Following my class, my name is Ray, and you can call me Peter. Today, I want to show you the history of superhero. This is three parts I will show you today. The first is the age of comic book. The second is the age of cinema movies. The last one is the age of computer games. So, have you seen a superhero movies before?
Yes.
Even everyone see a superhero movies, and in 1938, DC Comics Detective Comics starred the scene of superhero with Superman. Superman is the first American superhero. Superman gets a big success and led to the birthday of a member of Comic the Productions. But at the same time, the American superheroes is the superheroes all around the world. So we can call this time the golden age of superhero. But after World War II, superheroes were not no longer population, and at this time, the bigger superheroes DC has taken its heroes into a world called Justice. Do you know Justice?
Yeah, Justice.
And at the same time, the Marvel company was carved. The boss of Marvel told to Stanley to write some interesting stories about new superheroes, and Stanley create the new superheroes like Spider-Man and Hulk, Iron Man and Ant-Man. It can be said that most of the well-known heroes of Marvel never appeared come from. Even all the superheroes in Marvel come from Stan Lee. And this is the age of comic book. After that, when we go to the 21st century, with the development of scientists and technology, the industrial level of movies is also improved. CGI has widely used in movies work. So we can say the X-Men. X-Men was a very good work people on the market. After the September 11th attack, do you know that? Even everyone knew the attack. September 11th attack. Okay. After that, the American people went forward into a negative moves. Meanwhile, Sony complete. Sony movie complete. Production those movies called Spider-Man. It's a great movies. When I was a little boy, I come to cinema to see the Spider-Man. I always think it's very interesting superheroes. And and it was very cool. But when I grew up, I do some my own research on superheroes. I found it was wonderful movies for American people because connected the social backgrounds of the USA at that time, I can't have a feeling that Spider-Man was not just a movie. A good superheroes also can encourage people to face the future positively. In 2008, a superheroes movie called Iron Man come out. Do you know Iron Man? By Marvel. After that, the Marvel universe show was great. The Avengers in 2012 was a great success by Marvel. Marvel Stones has taken some time to make superheroes movies become the most popular movies in the world. However, at the same time, it also catch some problems, such as the use of CGI. When the X-Men was called, the CGI was only being used for something we can't make in the real world. But the Marvel, they use everything in CGI, so maybe nowadays we can say the Marvel movies is like cartoons because everything was by computers, not the real things. When Marvel create Iron Man, the Iron Man suit was real. But when we say the Avengers, the Infinity War, the Iron Man suit was unreal. Everything is unreal. The Iron Man, the suit can be created in the real world. Of course, Marvel is a great the history of movies will remember Marvel because they create a big success for superheroes. I hope the Marvel will reach the great success in the future. In 2018, we see a new game called the Marvel Spider-Man PS4. It was great games. I'm a big fan of Spider-Man, so when I enjoy this games, I'm feeling, wow, one day I can be a Spider-Man. And in fact, I think the superhero was only belong to the comic book or movies, but one day I found maybe the games was the future of the superheroes because everyone enjoy the games. And maybe in the future, everyone live in the games. So I think the age of the games for superheroes will come. So this is my summary. The comic book was passed yesterday. The movies are now dead, and the games will be the future, be the tomorrow.